Hi, so it's Paul here, and I want to show you some really useful hints and tips and tricks all rolled into one single video here. There's going to be quite a lot going on, so bear with me. I think you'll find some of the things that you see here quite useful. So, you might often find the need to have faces in adverts and things like that that you're composing for Facebook ads, and you have to always consider breach of copyright, personal infringement, those kinds of issues. But if you come to this website, generated.photos, you'll find a whole bunch of computer-generated images that you can use. So these aren't real people. They certainly look very real, but they're not. So you can use these without any danger of infringing copyright or getting any prosecution against personal infringement claims or anything of that nature. So you can play around with the settings here. I'm going to leave them just as they are, and I'm going to download these images. I've got a fantastic Chrome extension here, which is this little pink arrow that I'm pointing my cursor to at the top here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click that, select all, and then I'm going to download 33 images. So that'll take a little while to complete. Now it's opened a couple of the browse tabs here because they're part of those images on that web page it's discovered are GIFs, and I don't really want those, so I'm just going to close those browsers that it's opened. So if I go into the folder, I think it's just about finished doing the download now. There we go, let's just get rid of those three. Don't want those. So yes, put those in the recycle bin, please. So these are 30 images that it's downloaded. But as you can see, the file names aren't particularly user-friendly. I want to actually name those files with a person's name. So what we're going to do is a little trick from the old MS-DOS days from many years ago. So you open the start button on your computer. I'm in Windows 10, by the way. And if you type command, you'll get the command prompt come up. So that's the command prompt. So I'm going to highlight my folder name here, Control C, come into my command prompt, type CD, which means change directory, hit return. Then I'm going to do DIR, which is listing the contents of that directory or folder, whatever you wish to call it. And there you can see all those files are there also. So that's a bit like if I go back into File Explorer and I do view details. So you can see there's all the file names, and there they are again, what they look like at the MS-DOS prompt. So let's look at the bottom one there. So we've got V3093087, and down over here, look, V3093087. So what I'm going to do now is a bit of jiggery pokery. I want to get all of those file names into a file. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to type DIR, use the arrow symbol there, which is a redirect. So instead of listing the files to the screen, it's going to put them into the redirect. So dot dot means the folder above, the parent folder, and I'm going to create a file called photo file names .txt. So oops, I can't spell, I've mistyped that for some reason there. So I'm going to hit return, and then you'll see, if I refresh the window here and go up, sorry, not refresh, go up, you'll see, if I go date modified, go to the top, photo file names.txt. Let's just have a quick look in there. So I've got all those file names into a text file, but they're not quite how I want them. So now this is the clever stuff. We're going to open that with Microsoft Word, and we're going to do some tidying up. Let's just get rid of that there. So I'm going to come down to here, hit delete, because I don't want those. Let's go down to the bottom. Again, there's a couple of things there I don't want, so hit delete, get rid of that. So we're nearly there. We've got the file names here, but we've got all this other date, time, and file size information that we don't want. Now there's a really neat trick that you can do in Microsoft Word. If you hold the Alt button down on the keyboard and then highlight the text, you can do this, which is really clever, really cool. So I've highlighted that stuff that I don't want. Oh, missed, didn't quite get it right there. Let's try again. Come down. Whoops, I'm gonna go right across there. So I've highlighted that and I've hit delete. Voila. I just have the file names. So now I'm going to copy those, Control A, Control C, into a spreadsheet. Control V. Next thing I'm going to do is I want to, oh, that didn't quite go where I wanted it to go. Let's try again. Control V. There we go. Now the next thing I want to do is get some names of people. So I'm going to go to this other very useful website. So this one is called fossbytes.com and it's got a tool for generating people's names. So I've put in 30 people, male and female. Now, strictly speaking, if I'd have thought about this properly, I would have downloaded men's photos so I could match up with men's names and women's photos so I could match up with women's names, because obviously my photos are a mix and my names here are a mix. I should have been a bit more forward thinking, but I'm sure that you can see that you could do that. You could just download some men's photos, have men's names, and then just download some ladies' photos and have ladies' names. But anyway, don't worry about that. So what I'm going to do is export all these names to a CSV file, comma separated variable file, which is another Excel file. I'm opening it. So I've got those names there. So if I could do Control C. Now I'm going to put them in this column here and you'll start to see what's going to happen. Let's do that. Now I want to get, it's always good to avoid having spaces in file names. So I'm going to take the space character and I'm going to replace it with a hyphen there. Replace all, close that. Now, in column C, I've used an Excel concatenation formula. Concatenation joins the contents of various text and cell contents together. So I've used the word rename there. Now rename, as you'll see in a minute, is a DOS, an MS-DOS command prompt name. And I've used the ampersand to join that together with the contents of cell A and cell B to create a command. And the command says rename file v3001486.jpg to davidandtrade.jpg. So it's done that there for you. So now I've just created it in the first cell, and as you can with Excel, you just drag down and it populates all the cells. So very quickly and easy there, you can see that I've set up the rename command for all of those 30 files. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to copy those, Control C, put them on a clipboard, go back to my command prompt here. So I'm just going to do DIR once again. So you can see there the original file names. Now I'm going to do Control V. And what it's done is it's renamed all those files. If I do DIR again, there, look at that. So let's go to File Explorer. Go back to the folder I was in before, generate, and you can see all of those files have been renamed to the person's name. So that technique that I showed you in Excel is brilliant. If you've got a whole bunch of files that are named completely randomly, you can set the file names up inside of Excel. And of course, you can use the power of Excel to create formulas, auto population, sequences, numbers, fill all kinds of things. So it's very, very easy for you to create a new file name format inside Excel, set it up with the rename command, and voila, it's so easy to then rename a whole bunch of files in bulk. So if you had 100 files there or 300 files, you can see the same theory applies. Very easy to do, really, really little neat trick. So that's it. So I showed you how to get faces from a computer generated, or rather an artificial intelligence generated website. So that you can use them without fear of copyright infringement or such like. And I showed you how to get those files and rename them to something more meaningful than just the names that they already had. And this is particularly good, you know, if you've downloaded lots of images from a camera and they're like image one, image two, image three, da 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 da. You can go into your spreadsheet in Excel and you can either download the names as I showed you, or if it's doing something completely different, nothing to do with photographs, nothing to do with people's names, you can still use all these different formulas and other features inside Excel to create file names that are meaningful and that are of the structure that you want to have, like a naming convention or whatever it is that you want to do. And you can use the concatenation feature to very easily create the new file names. And it could be, for example, that you had, instead of people's names there, you might have something like, I don't know, image dash 0001 or something like that. So you can think of a new naming convention for your files that's going to be useful for you and that's going to work for you. And it could be that, for example, all your file names need to be the same number of characters. Whatever it is that you want to do, that shows you how to do it. So that's it. I hope you found that really useful. Quite a few different things being shown there all at the same time. So how long have we been running for? I think we've been running for about 10 minutes or so. So in a short space of time, we've covered a lot of ground, and I think you've seen some useful tricks. Hope that was good. Thanks for watching. Bye.